In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. When Hernan Cortes and his Spanish conquistadors went into what is now Mexico City, they encountered something truly horrendous: human sacrifice. Atop the Templo Mayor, the great pyramid temple in the city, they witnessed the Aztec priests slicing open the chests of men, women, and children, and offering up the still beating hearts to the demon they worshipped as gods, before casting their bodies down the temple steps. They were present and forced to watch the consecration of this temple, and reported that 80,000 were slaughtered over the space of 4 days. After their victory, of course, the Spaniards set about overturning the idols and putting a stop to this great evil of human sacrifice. But the mere presence and rule of the Spanish could never have been enough. Such depth of evil cannot be defeated by human endeavour alone. And so they rightly replaced the idol on top of the Templo Mayor with an image of Our Lady, and entrusted their mission once again to her. This is the context in which Our Lady then appeared to Juan Diego and gave the famous tilma as a sign. She who crushes the serpent's head would lead the fight against Satan in the Americas, and the result was an astonishing degree of conversion, almost 9 million baptisms in the space of 8 years. Where sin abounded, there grace did more abound. Just as Our Lady intervened then to defeat the darkness of pagan Mexico, so too we need to seek her intercession now, in the midst of the massive human sacrifice to the demons in our own time, the evil that is abortion. Human endeavours, even getting the right rulers into power, will achieve nothing on their own. Even if Donald Trump manages to pull off a victory in the US election, as seems unlikely at the moment, we shouldn't kid ourselves that this will be enough even in that country. Trust not in princes, as the psalmist says. For in the words of St. Paul, our wrestling is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of the world of this darkness, against the spirits of wickedness in the high places. In case anyone is tempted to doubt that this is primarily a spiritual conflict, we need only reflect on the situation we find ourselves in now in this country. As the government imposed its needless, unscientific and cowardly lockdowns, on the one hand they insisted churches had to close and public worship cease, and on the other hand, they not only permitted abortionists to keep functioning, but even made it easier with the awfulness of the home abortion pill. Stopping the public celebration of Mass, but increasing the killing of babies, could there be anything more clearly demonic? So we turn to Our Lady once more. And it is fitting, then, that we should have this Mass in honour of Our Lady of Guadalupe, the protectress of the unborn. But we do not only pray to stop abortion. We must also be willing to make reparation for so many abortions already committed. Now, the Mass is the very best prayer of reparation that we can make. And that is why we are offering this Mass in reparation for abortion. The sacrifice of Christ on the cross is sufficient to make satisfaction for all our sins and those of 1,000 other worlds like ours. But still, this needs to be applied to us. We need in some way to own it, for it to become our reparation. And we do this when we offer the Holy Mass. And yet, there is still something wanting on our part. We must be united with this saving action of Christ. And for this, the intention of the Holy Mass needs to spill over, so to speak, into our lives, in the form of penance and self-denial. We should be aware of the need to do penance for our sins, but let us not neglect the possibility of penance in reparation for others' sins, of taking upon ourselves the burden of the terrible evil in God's eyes that is abortion. Taken on their own, of course, our penances are feeble and incapable of making even the slightest reparation for sin. But when we are united to Christ in charity and we join our actions with his passion, then they gain a true dignity. They become a participation in his life-giving sacrifice and have a salutary effect. In this way, we become part of the solution, part of the reparation for sin, and we return in our own bodies the glory and honour due to Almighty God. May God bless you, and Our Lady of Guadalupe keep you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Nominus Domus Tuum.
Thank you.
you have